my mother had a sweet tooth, and one of the ways that she entertained us was to make chocolates and candy, and we'd make ice cream at home. So the idea of having sweets was always in my mind, and what got me into the ice cream part of it, as far as the store is concerned, is that I lived in Boston in the early 70s, and I rented an apartment about a half a kilometer from the guy who opened the first homemade ice cream store in Boston. His name was Steve Harrell, and he opened Steve's Ice Cream. He's now considered like the godfather of ice cream in the United States. I used to go in there and think, this is really cool. I would like to make ice cream someday. It took me a long time to get around to doing it. I didn't think Ed's would be as successful as it is. When I first did it, I thought I was just more or less creating a job for myself and making something that would be interesting for the community. And I think that I was lucky because I opened in the year 2000, and that's about when people were starting to look for something special instead of something normal. And so when I first opened, hardly anybody probably thought of themselves as a foodie, and now lots of people, probably you guys, think of yourselves as foodies, like you want to go to some place where there's something interesting and different from what you normally find in all the chain stores. So I worked really hard, I had a good idea, but I also was lucky to hit the wave of the foodie and interest. How has Ed's contributed to the community? Mainly by giving people a place to go. A lot of people go with their families, like the mom and dad and the kids, or the mom and the kids go out. And if you go in front of any of the stores now, you'll see that there'll be a group of people in front of the store in the evenings, and they're all standing there eating the ice cream and talking to each other. So it's kind of, I like to think of it as kind of like a pub for families, but with no alcohol, just with ice cream. Ed's does now about 150 different flavors, and this store, which is the biggest one we have, I think we do 48 flavors at one time. The ones I came up with was probably 130 of those, and then the staff, you know, staff have different ideas on different ones, but yeah, I've come up with a lot. When I first opened, the day I opened the first store, I had 9 flavors. Now I have 150. So over time you get ideas, you make new flavors. The most memorable thing to happen in the Roncesvalles store. To be honest, I don't work in this store that much, so my memories are usually of when something went wrong. And one of my closest memories now is about a week and a half ago, we had the air conditioner go out here in the middle of a really hot Sunday. And I had to come in and try and figure out why the air conditioner failed. But as far as finding memorable stuff that happened with people in the store, it's probably better to ask one of the store managers because they're here more time than I am. Oh, what did I do before I opened my ice cream shop? I graduated from university with a degree in physics, and after graduation, I grew up in the States, by the way. I've been in Canada for 31 years, or maybe a little more now. And after I graduated from university, I went to the end of the Peace Corps in the U.S. And after I got out of that, I got a job in the computer field. So I built computer packet switch networks for over 20 years. And you guys know what a packet switch network is because you use the internet. And the internet is a packet switch network. I built packet switch networks for companies before the internet existed. The busiest days are the holidays. It's funny because people say, oh, you look forward to holiday. Actually, it's like, well, holidays when we're the busiest and I'm the most tired and all the kids who work here are the most tired. Every holiday is pretty busy. The biggest holidays are the Victoria Day, May 2-4 weekend, and Canada Day. Canada Day may be slightly bigger, so it may be the biggest day of the year.
I never really saw that. How was your business during the winter?
Business in the winter is slow but steady. We stay open all winter. We close about 12 days of the year. We close Christmas Day, Boxing Day, and January 1st through 10th. And Christmas Day and Boxing Day is because of the holidays. January 1st through 10th, we use it to, because then there are no customers, we can take everything apart in the store and do a deep clean of the stores. Plus it gives some of the staff time to have off. Oh, you know there's a story? There is a story. So the story is that, how long ago? It's probably been 7 or 8 years ago. In November, I was making candy that we were going to dip in chocolate and sell for Christmas. So I had made this big baking tray full of candy that I'd overcooked it and it was slightly burnt. And so I thought, it's too burnt, I can't dip it in chocolate, people won't really like it. But I kept eating bits off the edges of it, thinking it kind of tastes cool, but it's kind of a burnt taste, it's a little bit too strong. And I had Alan, who's working in the kitchen right now, working for me. This was in the Beaches store. And I said, oh, Alan, you know what, just throw that away, like just toss it out. And Alan said, why don't we make an ice cream with it? It's too much of a burnt taste, but if we chop it up into little bits and we put it with sweet cream ice cream, it might tone down the burnt part. So we did that, we chopped it all up into bits, we put it with sweet cream ice cream, and I said, well, it tastes like when you eat the outside of a burnt marshmallow from a campfire, and so we called it burnt marshmallow, and now we burn candy every day in every store in order to make our burnt marshmallow ice cream. It's the most popular flavor we have. My favorite part of owning the ice cream shop is that it's a fun business. Generally, people are in a good mood when they come in, so everybody's having a good time. The only time somebody's not having a good time is if sometimes there's a little kid and they got vanilla and their sister got strawberry and then they have a fit because they decided they really wanted strawberry and so they had a little fit. But usually I just put a little bit of candy in a cup and give it to them and that cheers them up and they're quiet down. But other than that, it's really a fun place to work and it's fun to see families together.